Hey, what's up? It's Roy Wood Jr. and I'm here to look back at some of my favorite moments from this year's super weird Tokyo 2020 Olympics. Is it 21 or 2020? First up, a runner from the Netherlands falls down middle of the race, gets up, and wins the damn race. Look at this. How does she catch up with them so fast after falling? It's like she got the invincibility star from Mario Kart. Here's the downside to falling in the Olympics and getting right back up and winning a gold medal. Now in your real life, if you fall down, ain't nobody gonna be worried about you. Your ass could slip and fall down some icy steps. Everybody just gonna be like, yeah, you need to get up. I saw what you did in Tokyo. Shake it off. Next up, a British diver waiting his turn to jump in the pool spends his time knitting. Just chilling in the stands and just, oh yeah, don't bother me. I'm just gonna knit you a sweater. Which goes to show you just how underfunded the Olympics are this year. The divers have to make their own towels. I think that this is a more useful skill than the actual diving itself. The apocalypse is coming, people. Pretty soon we're all gonna be fighting and killing each other in the streets for supplies, and you probably want somebody on your team who can make a sweater. You don't need nobody that can do 2 triple backflip sow cows. Is that a swimming maneuver? I think that's gymnastics. Moving on. Well, well, well. If it isn't Novak Djokovic not handling pressure well during the Olympics. Got pissed off during his bronze medal match and took his racket and smashed it and bashed it and threw it off into the stands and was screaming and hooping and hollering. Hell, if you'd have done all of that to the ball, your ass would have won the match. Why are you blaming the racket? The racket does what you tell it to do. It ain't the racket's fault. If anything, the racket should be smashing your ass. Wait, hey, do you hear that sound? That's the sound of everybody who said Simone Biles was too emotional, who ain't saying shit about this man smashing a tennis racket. Here's another one of my favorite moments. It's when a robot that came from the future to kill Sarah Connor started playing basketball. Now, I don't know how y'all like your apocalyptic, murderous, robotic creatures, but I like mine without a jumper. If you gonna kill me, just kill me. Don't cross me over, too. The shit is disrespectful. This robot's so good at basketball, it's about to start dating a Kardashian. Seriously, this dude is so impressive that Drake probably about to start sitting courtside to watch it, sitting there rocking a Boston Dynamics jersey. One of my favorite things from the Olympics is the fact that the country of Russia is banned, but Russian athletes are not. So they just compete under the name ROC, or Russian Olympic Committee, or ROC. I'm gonna be real with you, I saw the ROC. I thought Jay-Z took some of his title money and started an Olympic team. So let me get this straight. Russia is allowed to compete in the Olympics under the name Russian Olympic Committee. But every time I try to show up to the club in VIP under the name Trevor Noah, folks got a problem. How'd that work? Anyway, props to the International Olympic Committee for sending a strong message to the rest of the world. Do all the drugs you want. Just make sure you set up a shell country first. Those are my favorite moments. Congratulations to all the athletes who competed, except for the Russian Olympic Committee. Fake ID having motherfucker.